vitamin D is technically not even a vitamin. As we learn more about biochemistry, we actually realize that vitamin D is more of a hormone than it is a vitamin. And one of its functions is multiple receptors on your pancreas. Now, I'm going to draw you a very rudimentary diagram here. This is your pancreas. So what happens is your pancreas is supposed to secrete insulin. And then insulin takes the sugar in your blood, your glucose, and puts it inside the cell. So it punches that, it basically the insulin's like a key. It unlocks a door in your cell and allows sugar to get out of your bloodstream, if this is the bloodstream. Okay, and blood's flowing that way and this is the cell. Then insulin allows that sugar to get out of your blood into your cell. If that sugar can't leave your blood, then your blood sugar goes up, and that's what creates an increase in blood viscosity. It's what creates glycation. It's what creates a number of different diseases. So the pancreas produces that insulin. But how? How does it produce that insulin? Well, vitamin D. You have on the pancreas a number of vitamin D receptors. They're called VDRs. And when you have adequate vitamin D and that vitamin D connects to those pancreatic receptors, it stimulates the production of insulin, which then can help you regulate your blood sugar. That's why not having adequate vitamin D leads to elevations in blood sugar. So just like if you're diabetic and you're damaging your kidney, you'll produce less vitamin D. If you're not getting enough vitamin D, your blood sugar is going to go up and potentially create a scenario where you might be more likely to become diabetic. So it's a catch-22. So it's very important to first and foremost get that vitamin D. Now, diabetes is a disease of choice, and not type 1 diabetes. I'm talking about type 2 diabetes. It's a disease where people, you know, pick the wrong choices, don't exercise, don't eat right, don't get adequate sunshine. And that's what contributes to it. It's not a genetic disease. Diabetes is not genetic. If you've been told that, you've been told incorrectly. It's a lifestyle disease. So vitamin D is just one of the first steps in making sure that you produce adequate insulin to get the sugar regulated, to get your blood sugar regulated. Some of the other key important functions. Many of you hear about vitamin D in the bone. And certainly, it's important. One of the things vitamin D helps do is it helps calcify the bone. And it does that in a couple of different ways. Number one, if we look at your small intestine, the enterocytes in the small intestine, so if we just kind of microscopically, you know, enlarge, and this is not to scale, this diagram, so the cells of the small intestine, they're called enterocytes. And these cells have to absorb the calcium when you eat it from your diet. So when you're eating calcium-rich foods from the diet, these cells are responsible for pulling that calcium into your bloodstream. What vitamin D does, there are vitamin D receptors on the nuclei of these different cells. And so what vitamin D does is it tells these cells to absorb calcium. And without vitamin D, these cells don't absorb calcium very efficiently at all. Your calcium absorption massively reduces to the point where it can create diseases like osteoporosis and rickets, which is a disease of children with vitamin D deficiency where their legs start to bow out. If you've ever seen somebody with bow legs, it's because as a child they had rickets, which is a vitamin D deficiency. Osteomalacia is another condition. Predominantly rickets and osteomalacia are the same thing. It's just that we call it rickets when it's in kids. We call it osteomalacia when it's in adults. But remember, vitamin D tells your small intestine to absorb calcium. And so if you don't have adequate vitamin D, that calcium you're eating may not be getting absorbed, and that's going to affect and impact your bone. Now, the other problem with that is it's not just going to impact your bone. Calcium plays a role in calcification of your bone and mineralizing your bone, but calcium also helps your cells talk to hormones and talk with hormones. So women, estrogen and progesterone, you require calcium for that hormone to work. Men with testosterone, you require calcium for that hormone to work. And this is why the downstream effects of vitamin D deficiency, if we're talking about vitamin D deficiency just affecting calcium, now what do we have? We don't just have a vitamin D deficiency, we have a calcium deficiency and all the things that come with that, like muscle pain, muscle cramps, muscle spasm, headaches, hormone imbalances, right? So vitamin D is prolific and profound in its effect, especially as it relates to calcium absorption. Hey, don't forget to check out the rest of the series right here. Make sure you hit subscribe below.
And as always, thanks for tuning in.